Hello, and welcome to another Lumbridge Knight guide for free-to-play OSRS. In this video, we're going to be looking at the mechanics behind OSRS Melee Combat. This guide aims to give you a basic understanding of how melee works and how to set your character up to maximise DPS. On the surface, OSRS combat seems very basic, and anyone familiar with the rules of, say, Dungeons & Dragons or rule-based tabletop games can imagine how it works. This is not far from the truth. Combat is indeed based on a role system. However, the actual system is a lot more complicated. This offers players an advantage, as understanding how this works can give you some big benefits in combat. Now I'm going to add a disclaimer up front. This guide aims to create a basic understanding of the mechanics, so I will use approximations and simplifications to try and make things easier to understand. Let me know in the comments if you think some advanced guides will be of use to you. The first thing to grasp is that OSRS runs on a clock or tick system. Each tick lasts for 0.6 seconds, which roughly equates to 100 ticks per minute. Why is this important? It is important to understand the way events stack to the end slash beginning of each tick. E.g., if I click a piece of food to eat at the start of a tick, the actual action will occur at the end of that tick or the start of the next. Certain actions can be used to take advantage of errors in the game clock and provide additional benefits. This is known as tick manipulation and will be covered in a separate video. For now, the only reason we need to know about ticks is to understand the speed of OSRS weapons. Another basic combat concept to remember is the combat triangle. To use a Pokemon reference, this is how the game's weaknesses slash super effectiveness works. Essentially, melee is weak against magic, but strong against ranged. Ranged is weak against melee, but strong against magic, and magic is weak against ranged, but strong against melee. This is a general rule of thumb for deciding how to equip your character based on the task slash fight ahead. The advantages and disadvantages associated with this are largely based on the worn equipment. So in PvP, most melee characters, for example, will wear ranged armor to try and mitigate against magic attacks, their inherent weakness. Before we move on to the melee combat skills, we need to briefly explain combat level. Your combat level is a guide for how effective you will be at fighting certain opponents, be that other players or NPC monsters. The exact calculation of your combat level is shown on the screen now. As you can see, it's pretty convoluted. Thankfully, OSRS Wiki has an easy calculator you can use. See a link in the description. As a rough guide, assuming you level all your combat skills evenly, you will increase a combat level with every 3 to 5 levels gained in the combat skills. It's more complicated, but unless you are looking for a very specific character build or are looking to PvP, you don't need to worry about it too much. Just before we get into the actual melee skills, it's also worth understanding some additional factors about melee weapons and attacks. Firstly, a weapon's damage has a type, either stab, slash, or crush. You need to be aware of this in order to maximise your accuracy. Additionally, most bosses or high-level enemies will be more susceptible to attacks of a certain type. For example, dragons are all weak versus stab, so this should help inform your weapon choice. Linked to attack type is fighting style or combat options. In basic terms, there are 4 categories: accurate, aggressive, defensive, and controlled. These correlate to the core melee skills and determine the XP awarded. They also determine which attack types, stab slash crush, your weapon will use. This is an important combination as depending on your requirements, you will need to try and match XP gained and the damage type being dealt to maximize your efficiency and or effectiveness. More on this later. Moving on to the relevant melee skills, starting with hit points or HP. This is obviously how much health a character has, and thus how much damage can be taken or given before your opponent dies. There isn't much else to this stat other than the fact you will gain 1.33 XP per point of melee, ranged, or magic damage dealt. It is impossible to train the melee skill and not gain HP XP unless receiving an XP reward from a lamp, quest, or similar. Magic, on the other hand, can be trained without gaining HP levels. See the appropriate guide. Other than that, you will regenerate 1 HP per minute and food is eaten during combat to restore HP quickly. Attack is linked to melee accuracy and thus how often you will damage an opponent. Higher attack equaling higher accuracy. Think of attack as the modifier for your attack rules in D&D. There are also a couple of things linked to this stat. Firstly, to wield better weapons than bronze and iron, you will need a higher attack level. For example, steel weapons require 5 attack, black 10, mithril 20, adi 30, etc. This is useful as better weapons offer higher attack bonuses and higher strength bonuses, which we will cover in the strength section. Roughly, this translates to an increased accuracy and potentially a higher max hit. To work out a reasonable approximation of how high your accuracy is, take your attack level in combination with your equipment type bonus, minus any defense bonus the target has against that style. So let's say I attack Obor with a Rune Scimitar using the accurate combat style, with an attack level of 40. I have my base attack level of 40, plus 3 for the accurate style, plus 45 slashing for the scimitar, minus 40 for Obor's defense bonus in slashing. This gives me a relative accuracy of 48. Say we use the same weapon but in the controlled style, this would be 40 plus 1 for the controlled style, plus 7 for my attack bonus, minus 35 for Obor's stabbing defense bonus, so my new relative accuracy would be 13. I can now compare these two figures and it's pretty obvious which will give me a higher chance of hitting Obor. Strength is linked to melee max hit or damage. The higher your strength level, the higher your potential melee damage will be. Sticking with the D&D analogy, think of strength as the modifier to your damage rolls. As mentioned in the previous section, weapons also have a strength bonus stat. This is not to be confused with strength level, as the two are not quite the same, i.e. a weapon with a strength bonus of 5 is not equivalent to plus 5 strength levels. You can see the base damage calculation on the screen now. For general play, you can assume that the higher your overall strength level and strength equipment bonus, the higher your melee max hit will be. However, this is the one stat you might need to occasionally calculate to ensure you are getting a higher max hit, as due to the multipliers involved, while you might have a higher equipment strength bonus, calculation rounds down such that at a strength level of 40, a Rune Scimitar and a Rune Longsword will provide the same max hit. You can see on the screen now the calculations for the Rune Scimitar and the calculations for the Rune Longsword, and you can see that they're both equal. So to attain a higher max hit, you will need to equip more items that offer a strength bonus. An Amulet of Strength, for example, gives an additional plus 10. Or if we fight in the aggressive style for a plus 3 bonus to our strength level. Therefore, see the values we calculated, and you can see that a Rune Longsword with a strength army has a max hit of 8, while the Rune Skimmy still has a max hit of 7. This is a useful example check because, as you will see later, the Rune Skimmy is faster than the Longsword. Thus, at strength level of 40 for general combat, you would be better off with the scimitar, and you will only increase your max hit with the longsword if using an amulet of strength or fighting with the aggressive fighting style.
Please like the video and support my content. Thank you, noble knight.
The first thing to remember of defense is that it is linked to avoiding damage, not reducing it. It essentially increases the chance of your opponent hitting a zero on you, otherwise known as a miss. Evasiveness would be a better description. Think of it in the same way as D&D attack rolls made against AC. This doesn't affect the damage roll, it affects your attacker's attack roll. There are also a couple of other things linked to this stat. Firstly, to wear better armor than bronze and iron, you'll need a higher defense level. For example, steel armor requires 5 defense, black 10, mithril 20, and so on and so forth. This is useful as better armor offers higher defense bonuses. Increasing defense levels does also increase your defense versus magic, however I will cover that in my magic combat basics video. Here is the exact equation to calculate your defense. However, all I think you really need to be able to do is to estimate your relative defense. To do this, you should simply combine your defense level with the relevant defense equipment bonus based on the incoming attack type. So if I had an account with 40 defense in Rune Plate Body, being attacked by a slash weapon, my defense would be 40 plus 80, so 120 relative defense. As always, the bonuses from equipment do not exactly match skill levels, but for a rough approximation, it's fine. The next thing to consider is the attack or tick speed of your weapon. Each weapon has an associated speed, usually with a value between 4 and 7. Lower is better, as this means the weapon will attack more frequently. You can check this value on OSRS Wiki. To put this into context, a weapon with speed 4 will attack 4 times in 10 seconds, while a weapon with speed 5 will only attack 3 times. This is also generally a set stat and cannot be changed. And now we make it to the final all-important concept of damage per second, or DPS. A higher DPS means more XP, and more XP means faster leveling. So it also means that you will kill your enemies faster, and thus, if you ensure you maximise your DPS, you are also maximising the damage you can deal and the experience you can gain. Here's a run through on the screen of the actual calculations. I do not recommend trying to calculate this manually, it's really not worth it. I don't think I have ever needed to calculate it. To get a rough and ready estimate, all you need to do is track your XP using the Runelite XP tracker, and then divide your XP rate by 240. Hey presto, you have your estimated DPS. Equally, if you look to understand the concepts covered so far, and so use the right combination of combat style, skill level, weapon and equipment, you should be able to get very close to your maximum DPS without having to calculate. To help illustrate the concepts covered, let's take the example of a player with base 40, full rune armour, an amulet of power and rune skimmy. They're going to fight Orbor, one of the free-to-play bosses. The first thing we need to do is head over to OSRS Wiki and check out Orbor's stat page. This tells us he is most susceptible to stab, as his defensive stat in that area is lowest, then slash and then crush. However, the difference between them isn't very big, so in this instance we can probably use whichever weapon we want. Next we should check his damage output, which is type crush and ranged, so we should look at armour that provides good protection against those types. Runeplate body does, so for now we will stick with this. Quick note, in reality, if fighting Orbot, you should pray protect from ranged. This will make him attack with melee more frequently, so crush attacks. Therefore, rune chain body will be the best choice, but this is outside the scope of this video. See my guide on fighting Orbor for more information. Next, we need to decide if our weapon of choice, the rune skimmy, is best for the job. I think it is, as I've decided I want to prioritize accuracy and more attacks over a higher max hit. What does this mean? Well, if you remember the comparison from the strength section between the rune scimitar and the rune longsword, I showed that weapons with a higher strength bonus doesn't necessarily guarantee a higher max hit. So let's look at two scenarios and compare their relative accuracy and their actual max hits. First up is using a rune skimmy in the accurate combat style. So we will utilize the scimitar's highest accuracy bonus of plus 45 in the slash damage type. Second, let's look at using a rune longsword in the aggressive combat style. Again, we will be utilizing the slash damage type as the longsword also has its best bonus of plus 47 in slash. Now, remembering to include the amulet of power and the plus 3 invisible bonus in attack with skimmy and strength for the longsword, we get the following results. This shows that the accuracy level of the two weapons is relatively similar, with the scimitar being more accurate, while the longsword has a higher max hit. In this situation, I would opt to use the rune skimmy, as plus 1 damage is not going to provide a higher DPS versus having a 20% higher attack rate. Remember the speed of the weapon, 4 versus 5 in this case. Combine this with the accurate style, making the scimitar more accurate in general. Thus, I would likely get a higher DPS against Orbor with the scimitar. Keep in mind, these are still rolls, and rolling always creates an element of chance. So betting on the slightly higher max hit may result in defeating Orbor quicker than betting on accuracy in more attack rolls, but there is a lower chance of this happening. More often than not, you would do better sticking with my logic and using the skimmy. And that brings us to the end of this video. I hope that this whistle stop guide is useful for you and makes sense. OSRS combat looks simple but is surprisingly complicated. I won't lie, I tried to keep this basic and found it quite a struggle. Please leave a comment with any feedback or questions, as I'm keen to hear them. And all that's left for me to say is, I've been the Lumbridge Knight, peace out and thanks for watching.